Hello, my name is Jason Johnson, and thank you for watching my videos. This is Chapter 4 Challenges for the textbook Prelude to Programming for a computer Intro to Computer Programming class that I teach. And this is going to be Chapter 4, Part 2. We're going to cover the programming challenges 5, 6, and 7. So the first challenge that we're going to look at here is we need to compute the income tax due on taxable income entered by the user. Given the data as shown in the following table, we need to be sure to include error checking to make sure that the user does not enter a negative number, and then we need to assume all entries are integer values and whole numbers. And we're going to set it up based on this table here. 0 to 49999 is 0 to 5% of amount over $0. 50 to 99999, 2500 is 7% of amount over 50,000, and then 100,000 and above is 6,000 to plus 9% of amount over 100,000. So let's take a look at this program here. We're going to start and we're going to tell the user to this program will calculate the income tax based on the amount of user's income. We're going to set the variable income to 0 and tax to 0. And then we're going to ask the user to enter the taxable income with no dollar sign. And so then we'll change the income variable to whatever that amount is. And then we're going to do our first choice here. And the first one is we're going to choose below 50,000. So we're going to do our first choice here between 0 and 49,999. And we're just going to say choice is the income less than 50,000. And if it is, we're going to come over here to the left-hand side and we're going to say is the income less than 0. If it's less than 0, this is our check here. If it is, we're going to say we cannot calculate the tax on a negative number. And it's going to kick it out. If it is greater than 0, and actually we probably should have it equal to or greater than 0 here, but in this case we're just going to say greater than 0. We're going to say take the tax and set tax variable to the income, whatever the income was, times 0.05, which is our 5%. And then we're going to output that to the user what that variable was. If it is over 50,000, or if it is not less than 50 and it's over 50, we're going to come over here and we're going to say, is the income less than 100,000? And we're going to do the exact same thing over here. We're going to say yes, and we're going to do our calculation and we're going to say 2,500 because that was based on our formula. Is the income minus $50,000 because we're only going to tax over a certain amount. So anything below 50, we're going to tax it 7% plus the 2,500. And then if it was over 100,000, we're going to tax 6,000 plus the income. So we're going to tax them 6,000 plus the income times 9%. So their tax bracket's 9% plus the 6,000. So let's run this real quick. We're going to set our income. We're going to set our tax. We're going to ask for the taxable amount. And let's do the easiest one first. Let's just say that we were at 500. So that's going to be less than 50,000. It's going to come over here and it's going to calculate our tax and we're going to say $500 is $25, which is our 5%. If we run that one more time and let's call this one, let's say this is going to be $60,000. It's going to come over here and it's going to say it's less than 100. So it's going to do this taxable amount and it's going to give us our amount 2,500 plus 7% of 50,000, which would be 3,200. And you could check that with the calculator if you want to make sure that your numbers are working. And then we run this one more time, and we're going to say this is 150,000. It's going to come over here, and it's going to say it's not less, and it's going to say 6,000 plus the income at 9%. Okay, so that was challenge number 5. Challenge number 6 is going to be a little bit more complicated, but it looks scary again, but it's pretty easy to do. We need to write a program that allows the user to input a dollar amount for an online shopping order and computes and outputs the shipping cost based on the following schedule. If we're shipping within the United, if it's based on order total, and then we're going to add a shipping fee depending on where it's shipping to. So if it's less than 50, it's going to be $6 in the United States, $8 to Canada, and then each up 50 to 100, 100 to 150, and then over 150 is all free. So let's look at the program here, and I'm going to scroll over, and we're going to set our variables here. We need to ask the user to put a shipping cost. We're going to say it's a shipping cost calculator. This program will calculate the cost of the shipping order. We're going to set our order amount, our country, because we need to make sure what our country is, whether it's USA, and we're going to put a U, or we're going to set that to U, and then our shipping cost to 0. And then we're going to say, how much is your order total? So this is going to set our order amount, and that's going to determine where it goes here. And then after we get our country, And then we're going to say, are you shipping within the United States or to Canada? And type U for USA and C for Canada. So if it's a U, it's a USA, we're going to come over here and it's going to say, now here's where we're going to check our three amounts. And this gets looks complicated, but it's simple once you break it down into bite-sized chunks. So we're just going to say, is the order amount less than 50? And we're going to come back over to our chart here. See, we're going to say less than 50, $6, 50 to 100, $9, 101 cent, $12, and then for free. So we're just going to have each one of those choices here. So we're just going to say, if it's less than 50, shipping cost is 6. And then it says, here's your shipping cost. If it's less than 100, see, that's less than 50. So it'll be 50. It's anything 50 and above. And anything less than 100, shipping cost will be 9. If it's less than or equal to 150, it'll be $12. And if it's over 150, that means anything over 150 will be 0. And then if it goes to Canada, we're doing the exact same thing for the Canadian side here. This exact same three-tier chart here. See, 1, 2, 3. So we're going to say, is the country yes or no? Or is it C or USA? If it wasn't U or if it wasn't C, it's going to kick out and say, we don't know where you can ship. Or we can only ship to the USA and Canada. If it was yes, we're going to come down and we're going to do our exact same chart here. We're going to say order amount 50, but we're going to change our shipping cost based on the schedule fee. $12, $15, and 0. So let's run through this a couple of times. We're going to put in our order amount, and let's say that our order amount is $50. Or let's say it's $49. And we're going to ship to the United States. And it's going to come over here to the left, and it's going to say it's less, so it's $6. Shipping cost is $6. So we know that part's working. Now, what you would want to do is have a user go through and check each one of these variables to make, or each one of these paths to make sure they're going to work. And I'm just going to check the Canadian side, and we're going to do over 150. So we're going to say anything over 150, let's just say 175. And we're going to ship to C for Canada. And it's going to come over to the right side and it's going to say it's greater than 150. So our shipping cost is 0. And if we try this one more time, and it doesn't matter what the shipping cost is, let's just put in $5,000 for a total. And then we put in, we want to ship to Mexico. So we put an M in. And no, it doesn't because we don't ship to, we only ship to USA or Canada. Now, if you wanted to add another layer to this and say that you wanted to ship to another country, and let's say that Mexico, you wanted to ship to Mexico or Great Britain or, you know, outside the United States, or just say anything outside the United States, you could have it say shipping without outside of these two countries could be another choice. And then you would just set these three choices up underneath over here and say what the shipping costs were. So it could be real easy just to add on to this program at this point. But that is challenge number 6 for chapter 4. Challenge number 7, we need to write a program that allows the user to enter his or her name. The program should output a username for the entry into the website. The user should be prompted to enter a first name, a middle initial, and last name. If the user doesn't have a middle initial, they should just enter none. In this case, the output will be a username that concatenates or puts them together, the first and last name with a dot between them. Or first name, if the user has a middle initial, the output username should be in the form of first dot middle underscore initial, or whatever middle initial is, dot last. And then so a user with Harold Wynn would have Harold Wynn for username, and a user who's Maria Anna Lopez would have Maria dot A dot Lopez for username. So let's take a look at this one. This one's a lot easier than the previous ones. We're just going to output to the user what this is doing. We're going to ask for a first, middle, and last name. And then we're going to set the username. So we have our first name, middle name, last name, and then we're going to set our username to nothing. So we're going to set all these to nothing. And then we're going to ask the user to put in what it is. So we're going to say enter the first name. We're going to set that variable. Middle name, if you don't have anything, just put none. And then we're going to say get your last name. And then it's going to say, is the middle name equal to none? If it is, we're just going to come over here and we're going to say, just pull in the first and last name and put a period between them. And that's what their username is. And then it's going to output username variable and output that. If it does, if the user does put a middle name in there, that means it'll go to this side and it will say, take the first, put a dot, middle, dot, last name. So pretty simple. Let's run this. So let's put in, I'm just going to put in my name. So we're going to put in a first name of Jason, and I'm just going to put in E for a middle initial, and then I'm going to put in Johnson for the last name, and then it's going to come down here, and it's going to, it, because there is a middle initial, it come in and it said, here was my username, and then it output, it said, your username is Jason.E.Johnson. And then if I didn't put in a middle name, we'll run that one more time, and we're going to come down here, and we're going to say, put in a first name of Jason, no middle name, and I'm just going to put none. and last name of Johnson, and then it's going to kick to the left side, and it's going to output the user of Jason.Johnson. And there we go. Nice and simple. So that was challenge number 7 for chapter 4. And this was the video for chapter 4, part 2. The link to part 1 will be below if you need to find that, or you can look on my playlist on my YouTube channel to find all of the videos on the Raptor. I hope this was helpful for you. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. If you're one of my students, make sure that you email me. Hope you have a great day. Stay safe, and remember to be excellent to each other.